Our next speaker is from the culturally rich country of languages, food, and traditions, Pakistan. She is Associate Professor for the Department of Peace and Conflict Studies at the United Nations Mandated University of Peace in Costa Rica, Chair of the Department of Sociology, and Associate Dean of Research of the School of Social Sciences and Humanities at the University of Management and Technology in Lahore, Pakistan. Please welcome Dr. Uzma Rashid, who will share about her efforts to making the teaching and learning practices centered on peace building more flexible and adapted to the various needs that arose due to the COVID-19 pandemic, and about the institutional adaptations that reflects the larger need for flexibility and a focus on contextually relevant approaches to address the changing needs of communities.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Uzma Rashid, currently working as Associate Professor at the United Nations University for Peace in Costa Rica. I'm in the Peace and Conflict Studies department here, in which I specifically also manage the programs for gender and peace building and religion, culture, and peace studies. It's been more than 3 years that I've been working here, and it's been an amazing experience, firstly of just being in Costa Rica, which is full of natural beauty and diversity of flora and fauna, with chickens, toucans, snakes, monkeys, and other animals visiting us at the workplace like it's no big deal. But then also of teaching in an institution where the student body embodies diversity in many different ways. There are students here from over 60 countries of different ethnic, racial, religious, and gender identities who make the experience of teaching here particularly unique. All of these students are broadly studying to prepare themselves to be peace builders in the future, through working with grassroots organizations, working in international bodies such as the UN, and in a variety of other ways, all geared towards achieving lasting peace. While it's always an intellectually stimulating experience teaching here, the challenges of teaching the diverse student body here multiplied manyfold as the pandemic unfolded. We had students here from countries who had families that were being severely impacted by COVID-19, and so they were dealing with the mental and emotional anguish of having to continue with their training as peace builders, training for a field that already necessitates conversations that themselves are difficult to have emotionally. So as the pandemic continued to unfold, institutionally, we faced the dilemma of whether to have classes in person or completely online. This was a development that had to be based on health concerns and feasibility issues related to traveling and whether or not travel was going to be possible for students from a lot of countries. But it was also rooted in the pedagogy that we adopt within the discipline of peace and conflict studies as well. The teaching and learning methodologies that we follow here in our department at UPEAS aim to bring together future peace builders so they can, in practice, engage with people in a range of conflict situations that they would be a part of after graduating. But how do you build that sense of community without being physically present in the same environment and engaging in group work, simulations, and other activities that are meant to prepare you for those real life situations? More importantly, how do you emotionally invest in this process as the world around you is falling apart? What does peace mean in such times and for people coming from conflict zones themselves or those who are subjected to violence in their everyday existence based on who they are? For example, students who are racially marginalized or are marginalized based on their gender and sexualities. How do you continue working towards preparing future peace builders at a time when peace itself is becoming more elusive than ever? We did not arrive at some magical answers and solutions to these very complex dilemmas. What we did eventually and continue doing is work towards creating a sense of community and camaraderie among students by organizing more events that brought students together even virtually and working with more mindfulness that the vulnerabilities of people in every field have increased manifold during the pandemic, in particular the field of peace, that seeks to deal with vulnerabilities at multiple levels and arenas. I do not think that one approach applies to all contexts, and solutions to this rapidly changing world have to be context specific. But if I've learned something in my academic work in the area of peace building, it is this flexibility and need to adapt to changing times while being mindful that peace is not just an ideal to attain at some state level, but also something we should aim to consider in our dealings with peace builders who themselves are also facing their own challenges in the pandemic. We need to be more cooperative in our approach. We need to come up with solutions that do not just advance our own agenda. For example, for me, it would be fulfilling my academic responsibilities. But we also need to be considering how we need to take into account the loss of the lives of loved ones we engage with, the loss of loved ones we ourselves have had to deal with, the emotional and physical toll it has taken. And we need to consider peace in a holistic manner through the kindness that everyone deserves.